Today we derived the wave function of progressive waves also, and we studied in detail about progressive waves. Okay, who will tell me what are progressive waves? Yes, raise hand. Who will tell me what are progressive waves and what is the other name of progressive wave? Before we start with standing waves, tell me what is the name of a progressive wave. Yes, Riddhi.
Ma'am, progressive waves are also called as traveling waves. These yes. waves that moves in the forward direction with a certain velocity and always at amplitude is remain at constant time.
Yes, very good. So what are progressive waves? They are also called traveling waves because they travel in the forward direction with certain velocity always, such that their amplitude remains constant with time. So in this case, we ignored the damping forces, and that's why we say that the amplitude remains constant. Now, who will tell me what was the wave function that we derived for a progressive wave? Who will tell me the formula for wave function for a progressive wave? Wo kis form ka hota hai? Yes, anyone? What is the formula for progressive wave? Yes, students, progressive wave ka wave function kya tha that we derived yesterday? Yes, hurry up, come on. Puri, humne to derivation ki thi, periodicity bhi check ki thi. I am just asking the formula. What is the formula? Yes, Samriddhi.
Ma'am, a sin 2 pi by lambda Vt plus minus x.
Y is equal to a sin 2 pi by lambda Vt plus minus x. So if it is moving towards right, Vt minus x. And if it is moving from right to left, then Vt plus x it will be. Okay? So now we are going to do standing waves. I told you they are also called stationary waves. Why they are called so, we will do that in detail. So I told you how standing waves are produced. Kaun batayega? How are standing waves produced? Kal maine iski statement karwa di thi aapko. Who will tell me? Only Riddhi and Samriddhi are coming up with the answers. What about other students? Yes. Riddhi, Samriddhi ke ilawa koi aur hai jisko aati hai definition? How are standing waves produced? Yes, students. How are standing waves produced? Chalo, aap hi batao Riddhi phir.
Ma'am, standing waves are produced in the opposite direction due to superposition of two identical progressions.
Yes, you can say standing waves are produced due to superposition of two traveling waves moving in the opposite directions. So, kal maine aapko bataya tha ki kaise wo opposite direction mein superimpose karti hain. And yes, we were doing principle of superposition of waves, right? So, wo complete nahi hua tha, wo kar lete hain pehle. Theek hai? So, principle of superposition of waves. So, I told you that when there is a particle in a medium. Suppose there is water medium या कोई भी gas है, container है, उसमें बहुत सारी waves independently travel कर रही हैं. That then if we concentrate on one particle of the medium, it will suffer displacement due to different waves. And resultant displacement of that particle due to number of independent waves, it will be vector sum of individual displacements. That is called principle of superposition. Ab vector sum ka meaning ye hai that we have to take into account the direction of superimposing waves. If two waves are traveling in the same direction, then amplitudes will get added up. If two waves are traveling in opposite directions, their amplitudes will get subtracted. And if they are moving at certain angle, we have to find the resultant displacement. So that means resultant displacement of a particle due to a number of independent waves is the vector sum of individual displacement. That was principle of superposition, and we are taking two cases. Superposition can be of two types, constructive and destructive superposition. Constructive and destructive superposition. Constructive superposition means when the waves are traveling in the same phase. So, ye suppose wave 1 hai having displacement y1. Usi phase mein dusri wave bhi travel kar rahi hai, that we are showing with dotted line having different amplitude, say y2. Okay, then crest is falling on crest, trough is falling on trough. So, resultant displacement will be the sum of two displacement. We will say y equal to y1 plus y2. So, why we are adding the amplitudes in this case? Because the waves are in same phase. Waves are traveling in the same direction. So, it depends upon their direction, right? It depends upon their direction. Second case is destructive superposition. Ye likh lo. Constructive superposition ki definition likh sakte ho aap, write down. Superposition is said to be constructive. Superposition is said to be constructive if two waves traveling in the same phase, if two waves traveling in the same phase traveling ki jagah travel kar lo, travel in the same phase in such a way that crest falls on crest of other and trough of one falls on trough of other. In such a way that crest of one falls on crest of other and trough of one falls on trough of other. And amplitudes get added up. So such a superposition is called constructive superposition. Okay, so superposition is said to be constructive if two waves travel in the same phase such that crest of one falls on crest of other, trough of one falls on trough of other, and amplitudes are adding up, right? So such type of superposition will be constructive. Destructive superposition, when the waves are traveling in opposite directions, opposite phases. So this is your first wave. Second wave is traveling in the opposite phase. We are showing smaller amplitude also. This is the displacement function for the second wave. Now in this case, net amplitude will be subtraction of the two, bigger minus smaller, because they are traveling out of phase. So the resulting wave as a result of superposition will be y equal to y1 minus y2, bigger minus smaller. This kind of superposition where crest of one falls on trough of other and trough of one falls on crest of other, that is called destructive superposition. So when the waves will be traveling in opposite phase in such a way that crest of one falls on trough of other and vice versa, then amplitudes will get subtracted and this type of superposition will be called destructive superposition. Okay, amplitudes will get subtracted and this type of superposition, that is called destructive superposition. Is that fine? So what is constructive superposition? What is destructive superposition? Is that clear to you? Okay, so if you want to write destructive superposition, you can write as well. So superposition is said to be destructive if two waves travel in the opposite directions in such a way that crest of one falls on trough of other and vice versa, and their amplitudes get subtracted, that superposition is called destructive superposition. Matlab bilkul waise hi likh dena, bas reverse likh dena uska, theek hai? So you can frame in your own words. We can also show the superposition in this way. Ek aur way hai superposition ko show karne ka. Suppose we have pulses. This pulse humne, means two people are standing and they are holding two ends of a rope. Ek ne udhar se rope pakdi hui, ek ne udhar se. Theek hai? Ye idhar wala jo person hai, wo usme ek up jerk deta hai, idhar wala bhi ek up jerk deta hai. to produce pulse from both the sides. So long rope hai, one pulse travels here, second pulse travels here. Okay, after some time they will reach here, they will reach closer. Because still it's going this side and this is going this side. When now the moment will come, they will cross each other. Okay, both their crests, they are superimposing with each other. So when the crest will fall on crest, their amplitudes will get added up, and at that time it won't be possible for us to find the displacement, which pulse belongs to which one. Individual jo distinction hai wo possible nahi hogi, theek hai. But after this moment again we will see that pulses get separated, and this is one and this is two. Okay, two is still traveling that side and one is still traveling towards right side, and after that the pulses reach a large distance. So pulse one has reached right side and pulse two has reached the left side. So this portion is showing constructive superposition. So this is also one of the ways of showing type of superposition. Okay, this is also showing constructive superposition. I hope this is clear to you. If any doubt to any student, you can come up, you can tell me. Kisi bacche ka doubt hai? Okay. So then destructive superposition can be shown in the similar way. Ab kya karenge? The person standing there now holding the other end will give it a down jerk. Or either wala person up jerk de raha, either wala person down jerk de raha. So here the wave is coming flipped. Second wave is traveling in opposite phase now. Theek hai? After some time they will come closer. Still it is traveling this side and one is traveling this side. Now there will be a moment when they will cross each other. So crest of one will be falling on trough of two. So at that moment there won't be any disturbance in the way. Lagega hi nahi ki koi pulses mein se pass kar rahi. But this is showing us subtraction of amplitude. This is showing us destructive superposition right now, because their amplitudes were same. So net cancellation is taking place and we will see a straight rope, but disturbance was there. Yahan pe abhi bhi superposition ho raha hai. Theek hai? After a moment, after the next moment, we will again see them separated. This will be two, this will be one, and two has reached this side, one has traveled to that side. So this is showing destructive superposition of waves. This is showing destructive superposition. So any doubt regarding this? Clear? Okay, fine. So next is standing waves now. So what are standing waves? Wo to maine aapko bata diya ki we take two identical progressive waves. एक जैसी ट्रांसवर्स वेव्स ले लें या एक जैसी लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव्स ले लें, ठीक है. बट इफ दे ट्रेवल इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शंस एंड देन दे सुपरइम्पोज, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स विल बी फॉर्म्ड. दोज पैटर्न्स, दोज वेव्स विल बी कॉल्ड स्टैंडिंग वेव्स और स्टेशनरी वेव्स. आई गेव यू एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ रबर बैंड. सो रबर बैंड इज स्ट्रेच्ड बिटवीन टू फिक्स पॉइंट्स. आपने रबर बैंड पकड़ा हुआ है, अनदर पर्सन कम्स and plucks it in the center and releases it. उसको सेंटर से ऐसे करके छोड़ देता है. तो आपको इस तरह से कुछ patterns दिखते हैं. Those patterns are called normal modes and these waves are called standing waves or stationary waves. ठीक है, I'll show you a wave model where you can see similar pattern. ठीक है, इसमें similar pattern आपको ये string में नजर आएगा. देखिए उसमें बीच बीच में थोड़ा ऐसे लगेगा, थोड़ा डिम सा भी हो रहा है. रबर बैंड में भी ऐसे ही होता है ना, रबर बैंड के केस में भी ऐसे ही होता है ना. उसमें भी बीच बीच में पैटर्न्स कई बार क्लियर नहीं होते. सो यू कैन सी पैटर्न्स, ऐसे बनता है ना रबर बैंड में. So these are standing waves. Okay, these are standing waves. तो ये normal modes दिख रहे हैं हमें. ये अभी हमें fundamental mode दिख रहा है, center वाला fundamental mode दिख रहा है. Okay, fine. If we pluck that rubber band from 1/4 of length, from 1/3 of length, तो अलग अलग patterns बनेंगे. अगर हम बिल्कुल सेंटर से प्लग करेंगे तो ये फंडामेंटल मोड बनेगा, दिस वन जो मैंने आपको अभी शो की. सो दीज आर स्टैंडिंग वेव्स. ठीक है, चलिए अब इनकी ग्राफिकल जनरेशन देखते हैं. ग्राफिकली हाउ कैन वी शो स्टैंडिंग वेव्स एंड व्हाई दे आर नेम्ड सो. क्या चीज स्टेशनरी है यहाँ पे? हम देख रहे हैं कि देर आर टू वेव्स, वन इज मूविंग इन वन डायरेक्शन, अनदर वेव इज मूविंग इन द अदर डायरेक्शन. ठीक है, जैसे कि आपको ये पर्टिकुलर एग्जांपल दिया, वी हैड टू फिक्स्ड एंड्स, दो फिक्स्ड एंड्स थे जिसके बीच में ये जो स्प्रिंग अटैच्ड था. ठीक है, तो लेट अस मार्क, एक मिनट, इतना बना लो कि दो वेव्स आ गए. ठीक है, इतनी लेंथ बनाइए. ड्रॉ फाइव इंटरवल्स. लाइक दिस. ठीक है, अब ये मार्क करिए जहां जहां पे वेव फेज चेंज करती है, वेयर इट चेंजेस डायरेक्शन, मार्क द इंटरवल्स देयर. इन बिटवीन ऑल्सो बिल्कुल सेंटर से भी इंटरवल्स मार्क करिए. अगेन वी आर डिवाइडिंग अ टाइम पीरियड इनटू फाइव इक्वल पार्ट्स, टी इक्वल टू जीरो, टी बाय फोर, टू टी बाय फोर, थ्री टी बाय फोर and 4t by 4. So we divide a time period into 5 equal parts, each of t by 4 interval. So 5 intervals would be 0, t by 4, 2t by 4 means t by 2, 3t by 4 and 4t by 4 means t. Ye banao pehle, draw this. Then we will show standing wave in one complete time period. How a standing wave propagates in one complete time period. So we are taking five different moments, five different intervals of time. Okay, so as we said that there are two traveling waves traveling in the opposite direction. So let us say this is first traveling wave moving from left to right. This is first traveling wave that is moving from left to right. Then we take another traveling wave which is traveling, of course, in the opposite direction, because when we want to discuss standing wave, we have to take two waves traveling in the opposite direction. So I'm using a different color and I'll also show that wave with a dotted line. So ye different डायरेक्शन में आ रही है, ये राइट से लेफ्ट की तरफ आ रही है. फेज सेम ही है अभी टू स्टार्ट विद, बट ये डायरेक्शन ऑपोजिट है. इसकी डायरेक्शन इस साइड पे है. इट इज कंपल्सरी टू मार्क द डायरेक्शन. नाउ इन दिस केस व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस? द सुपरपोजिशन इज कंस्ट्रक्टिव. क्रेस्ट इज फॉलिंग ऑन क्रेस्ट, ट्रफ इज फॉलिंग ऑन ट्रफ. सो हाउ कैन यू ड्रॉ द रिजल्टिंग वेव? This is your resulting wave. This is your standing wave as a result of superposition. ये आपकी standing wave है. So we will be drawing with a thick line always. The first case is clear to you. We take two traveling waves, two progressive waves moving in the opposite direction. Let us start with same phase first of all. Let us assume that they are starting in same phase. अब सेकेंड इंटरवल पे क्या होगा? दिस वेव, फर्स्ट वेव, ये जो व्हाइट वाली थिन वेव है, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस, इसने टी बाय फोर इंस्टेंट में 1/4 डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल कर लिया, ठीक है। आप कह सकते हो टी बाय फोर पे यहाँ है, टी बाय टू यहाँ है, थ्री टी बाय फोर और ये यहाँ टी, ये एक कंप्लीट वे वन टाइम पीरियड में कंप्लीट करती है जर्नी। तो इसने 1/4 डिस्टेंस कवर कर लिया है, और सेम वे अदर वेव ये पर्पल वन, इसने भी 1/4 डिस्टेंस कवर कर लिया है पहले इंटरवल में। तो अब हम इनको स्टार्ट करेंगे यहां से, 1/4 पोर्शन काट दो, अब इसको हम यहां से स्टार्ट करेंगे व्हाइट वेव को, ये देखिए वहां से स्टार्ट करेंगे, 1/4 पोर्शन कट कर दो, ये यहां 1/3 वेव हमने ड्रॉ की, एंड कंटिन्यू इट फॉरवर्ड, जहां जहां जा रही है इसको फॉरवर्ड कंटिन्यू कर दीजिए, एंड मार्क द डायरेक्शन ऑल्सो, इट विल बी ट्रेवलिंग ऑलवेज फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट। Now cut 1/4 portion of this purple wave, second wave also, and start it from here. 1/4 cut करने के बाद यहाँ से start करेंगे हम। So start it from here now. And mark its direction as well. This is the direction. I hope this step is clear to you. आगे देखो और समझ में आता जाएगा। And what will be the standing wave in this case? This type of superposition is destructive. Crest is falling on trough and vice versa. So at each part, the wave will be like this. Due to destructive superposition and equal amplitudes, what will happen? Cancellation will take place and this will be the standing wave. So this is very surprising. We have never seen a wave that assumes the shape of a straight line also. So the concept of standing waves is very much different from the progressive waves. And these stationary lines are visible when we see that model also. When you stretch a rubber band yourself, aap dekhoge wo jo aapko dim se pattern nazar aate hain, usme straight line pattern bhi dikhta hai. To standing wave hoti hai that can assume the shape of a straight line also. That traveling wave never takes. Theek hai? Ab next instant pe kya karenge? Ab usne हाफ डिस्टेंस कवर कर लिया, तो कट दिस पोर्शन ऑफ व्हाइट वेव, अब हम इसको यहां से शुरू करेंगे। अब ये व्हाइट वेव को हम यहां से स्टार्ट करेंगे, मार्क इट्स डायरेक्शन, और पर्पल वेव ने भी हाफ डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल कर लिया, हम इसको यहां से स्टार्ट करेंगे, स्टिल मूविंग इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन, मार्क द डायरेक्शन। But now the superposition is again constructive. Crest is falling on crest, trough on trough. So this will be our standing wave in this case. अब ये वाला pattern बन जाएगा, ठीक है? अब 3t by 4 instant पे ये जो white wave है, it must have travelled 3/4 of distance. Now we will start it from here. बस इतना distance है, यहाँ से start करेंगे. White wave को हम यहाँ से start करेंगे. White wave, mark the direction. और ये जो purple wave है, इसने भी 1/3 यहाँ तक distance cover कर लिया है. Now we will start it from here. यहाँ से शुरू करेंगे. Again mark its direction, and you can see again destructive superposition is taking place. Again the standing wave will assume the shape of a straight line. So once in a time period, standing wave assumes the shape of a straight line twice. दो बार standing wave एक straight line की shape acquire करती है. Once in a time period हमने देखा. ठीक है? अब क्या करोगे आप? When t is equal to t, it has completed one round. तो अब फिर ये पूरी की पूरी wave यहाँ तक cut कर दोगे आप, फिर से यहाँ से start करोगे. बिल्कुल पहले वाला case. ठीक है? Now you will again start as before, which, because it has completed one round, it has completed a time period. Same way purple wave, इसको भी आप यहां से ही show करो in the same phase. ये देखो इधर पूरी काट दो, ये यहां से शुरू करो. वो ट्रेवलिंग इन द सेम फेज, So again, crest is falling on crest, trough is falling on trough. Constructive superposition is taking place. This is our standing wave. So this is graphical generation of standing wave. तो हम देख रहे हैं कि कैसे पैटर्न बन रहे हैं. तो ये एक स्टैंडिंग वेव की ग्राफिकल जनरेशन है. आई नो दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज न्यू फॉर यू, बट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस. ड्रॉ इट वंस, देन वी विल डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग स्टैंडिंग वेव. Is that okay? So there are two key words for standing waves: nodes and antinodes. What are nodes and what are antinodes? Let us define. Nodes are the points on standing waves that are permanently at rest. जहाँ पे displacement zero है, वो points. जहाँ पे velocity zero है. The particles at those points are permanently at rest. Those points are called nodes. So, likh lijiye the positions of zero displacement. Okay, where the particles are permanently at rest, these points are called nodes. So, let us show nodes. मेरे पास यहाँ पे space नहीं है. तो अगर आप देखो कि ये वाला point, always nodes are there. यहाँ पे displacement हमेशा zero है. So, I write N here for node. Then we see this point, ये हमेशा rest पे रहता है. हम सिर्फ thick line को देख रहे हैं. Thick line में जो mean position पे रह रहा है वो वाला point. तो ये second node है. फिर इसके बाद ये जो points हैं, ये always at rest है. This is node and this is node. So we have marked the positions of zero displacement. These points are called nodes. And antinodes are the positions of maximum displacement. जहां पे पार्टिकल की स्पीड मैक्सिमम है. ठीक है, तो हर दो नोड्स के बीच में ये होगा. एवरी टू नोड्स के बीच में एक एंटी नोड है जहां पे डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैक्सिमम है. ये देखिए डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैक्सिमम. सो दीज पोजीशंस बिटवीन टू नोड्स आर एंटी नोड्स. दीज आर एंटी नोड्स. ठीक है, बट यू डोंट थिंक कि जहां पे नोड्स पे डिस्प्लेसमेंट जीरो है वहां पे कोई प्रेशर डेंसिटी में भी चेंज नहीं हो रहा, कोई वेरिएशन नहीं हो रही. रादर स्ट्रेन विल बी मैक्सिमम एट दोज पॉइंट्स. सो हाउ डू वी डिफाइन नोड्स? क्योंकि आपने देखा था जब हमने डिस्ट्रक्टिव सुपरपोजिशन किया, वी वर अज्यूमिंग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, बट उसके अंडर वो सुपरपोजिशन हो रहा था. ठीक है, वहां पे स्ट्रेन मैक्सिमम था, कैंसलेशन हो रही थी एम्पलीट्यूड की. ठीक है, सो राइट द प्रॉपर डेफिनेशन ऑफ नोड्स नाउ. Nodes are the points on stationary waves having zero displacement, zero velocity, but maximum strain. Strain means maximum changes in density are taking place. Maximum changes, maximum variations in pressure and density are taking place there at those points. Right? So nodes ki definition likhiye. These are the positions, these are the points on standing waves having zero displacement, zero velocity, but maximum strain. Strain means maximum variation in pressure and density. And on the other hand, antinodes pe particles bilkul relaxed hain. When they are maximum displaced, wahan pe strain bilkul nahi hai. Wahan pe strain zero ho jata hai kyunki wo jahan jana chahte the wahan tak chale gaye hain. They are maximum relaxed. तो लिखिए एंटी नोड्स की डेफिनेशन. दीज आर द पॉइंट्स ऑन स्टेशनरी वेव्स हैविंग मैक्सिमम डिस्प्लेसमेंट बट मिनिमम स्ट्रेन. मैक्सिमम डिस्प्लेसमेंट बट मिनिमम स्ट्रेन. और अब आपको समझ भी आ गया होगा कि व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड स्टैंडिंग वेव्स, बिकॉज वट एवर यू नो अ वेव कैरीज एनर्जी फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. सो वट एवर एनर्जी इज बींग कैरीड इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन is being cancelled in the opposite direction. क्योंकि हमारे पास एक और वेव है जो ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में ट्रेवल कर रही है. ठीक है, सो दैट्स वाई दीज वेव्स आर कॉल्ड स्टेशनरी वेव्स, बिकॉज द नेट ट्रांसफर ऑफ एनर्जी इज जीरो. इट इज नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस इन ईदर डायरेक्शन. वट एवर एनर्जी इज गेन्ड इन वन डायरेक्शन इज लॉस्ट इन द अदर. तो ये क्वेश्चन ध्यान से करिए. why are the standing waves called so? Why they are named so? Because whatever energy is gained in one direction is lost in the other. So that net transfer of energy is zero. That's why they are called standing waves or stationary waves. Kyunki energy transfer nahi ho raha. Ek progressive ya traveling wave le to usme energy transfer hota hai. Theek hai? Okay, fine.